Welkom in deze allereerste aflevering van Brain Freeze. Mijn gedachten over comics, cool en vers geserveerd. Ik ga je meenemen in deze machtige en wonderbaarlijke werelden van de comics. Een ongelooflijk zalig medium. Ik ga dit doen door interviews, reviews, specials over zowel schrijvers als artists als events. En voor deze eerste aflevering heb ik een heel mooi special over Facts. Facts is een hele grote beurs die afgelopen weekend in het Expohallen in Gent was. Er was heel veel volk, echt ongelooflijk veel volk. Kijk maar naar de volgende beelden. I wake up, every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip. Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. And I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Bonkers. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip.
Bonkers.
Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. And I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Yeah, I'm man,
in the floor now.
Back then.
I wake up, every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip.
Bonk, 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 bonk.
Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Naast mij staat Sibylski, talent scout voor Marvel en ook schrijver van verschillende series, gelijk X-Infernus. Hello, Mr. Sibylski.
Yeah, how are you?
Fine, and you?
I'm very fine, thanks. Thanks for having me on.
You're welcome. You like it here at Facts Ghent?
Oh, I'm loving it. I'm having a great time. It's my first trip to Belgium in many years, my first convention in any of the Benelux area, and I'm having a wonderful experience.
So next year, you're back?
I would love to come back. Definitely.
Cool. You wrote magic back into the X-Men environment.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very thankful for it because I really like the character. Are you still involved in the upcoming things about her?
You know, they asked me. You know, just Chris Yost and Craig Kyle kind of put her on the path to coming back in New X-Men. And when I was writing the X-Infernus series, I got their blessing and, you know, kind of worked things out with them about what they had planned and took the, you know, wrote my own story based on their ideas. And now that Magic is back, I still work at Marvel as the talent scout, the talent manager. And I'm part of the X office as a consultant because I just love the X-Men. So when some of the editors, Nick Lowe and Axel Alonso, Janine Schaefer, they come to me sometimes and ask, oh, would Magic do this and would Magic do that? And I kind of just give my input, you know. And Zeb Wells is writing the New Mutants book, which is fantastic. And when he was launching that, him and I spoke briefly about, you know, my take on the character. And he's taken what I built on what Craig and Chris did, he's taken what I kind of did and built it, and I'm just pleased as punch with what Zeb is doing, and he's really bringing a new life to the character back in the Marvel Universe. So.
Yeah, and you also wrote the Darkhawk. Yeah. Any plans for this? Are you going to continue with Darkhawk?
I'm not going to continue with Darkhawk. You know, Darkhawk was in the Loners series that I wrote, and when Bill Roseman, who is the editor of all the Cosmic Universe books, wanted to use her, he was kind enough to give me two issues to kind of take Darkhawk from the Loners and send him off into space.
I really love the story. Really, you really did a good work. Because Darkhawk is like, it's a C B character from Marvel, and you really made him like a more up to it. I'm really looking forward to seeing him more in like in War of Kings and stuff like that.
Yeah, thank you. No, he played a very big part of War of Kings, and I was so psyched to see a character, yeah, like you said, a BC character, but we kind of get boosted up to more of a starring role in a major Marvel miniseries. And I know there are plans for him coming up. I can't say what they are just yet, but 2010 I think is going to be a big year to build even more with Darkhawk and, you know, make the fans, you know, who really do love him, happier even.
And what's your upcoming work at Marvel?
Right now, I'm focusing more on the talent scouting. I'm traveling around to all the different countries and the different conventions looking for pencilers, inkers, colorists. Unfortunately, I can't look at writers. That's just one thing. As a writer myself, Marvel says, you know, they don't want me to look at writers. So I'm doing that for now. And then I have some X-Men stuff that's going to be coming up at the beginning of 2010. I'm not sure exactly which month, January or February.
After Nation X.
Yeah, after Nation X. Actually, it's one of the stories I'm writing is a story that's going to be in. There's a Nation X miniseries that's launching. I'll have a story in issue two, and then I have one other thing planned in the X-Men universe, which will be, you know, later in the springish. And then I have some things that I'm pitching now, a couple Spider-Man things, you know, a few other books that I'm just trying to branch out. As much as I love the X-Men, I love the entire Marvel Universe, so I want to see what other toys I can play with.
Of course. And you said it a couple times before, you're a talent scout for Marvel. Yeah. Here at the convention.
Yes.
You find any talents?
I did. You know, there were a couple talents that I was coming specifically to meet that I spoke with on Facebook earlier, and they emailed me, so we set up some meetings. Had some very successful meetings with them, and then other people, just students at art schools and some people in the artist alley would come, and I reviewed the portfolio, and I have a couple people that I think will be able to, you know, work at Marvel in the future.
All right, cool. Thanks for the interview, and well, hopefully we'll see each other at another convention.
Definitely. Okay, thank you.
Zo, dit was de allereerste Brain Freeze aflevering. Hopelijk heb je ervan genoten en zie ik jullie volgende week terug. Houd hoofd koel. Cool.